Welcome.
Thank you.
You founded the Hare Krishna movement some 7 years ago in 1967, did you not?
Yes.
In a capsule, what is the movement?
The movement is to awaken God consciousness of the human being. The human being is distinguished from the animals, that the animals cannot understand what is God.
Mm-hmm.
And if the human being also does not understand what is God, then he is an animal.
I see. And so your movement is to bring about an understanding of God among human beings.
Yes.
And Hare Krishna means what?
Hare Krishna means addressing the energy of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hare means the energy of God, and Krishna means God.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you were here yesterday and to attend your annual festival that was held here in Golden Gate Park, and we were there too. Mm. And in fact, here it is. Mm. A few thousand people came out to hear it. How many people are now disciples of the Krishna consciousness movement?
Dedicated life, about 10,000.
About 10,000 dedicated
in the Western world.
Mm-hmm. Your Grace, is there any significance at all in the shaved head? Why aren't heads shaved?
We keep ourselves very clean, that's all.
Oh, it's just a cleanliness thing?
Yeah.
Is there any significance in the color of the robe?
At least at the present moment, people think that by keeping long hair, it becomes very beautiful.
I see.
Yes. We are against it.
Mm-hmm. Just as simple as that. Is there any significance in the yellow robes?
Yellow robe is the dress those who are dedicated.
Mm-hmm. Could very well have been a blue robe. It's just something that was arrived at.
This saffron.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Your Grace, why do you feel that so many people are pulling away from the traditional religions in this country, such as Christianity and so forth, and going for the trying to understand the Eastern religions? We hear a lot of swamis and gurus and other type of yogi and so forth. Why do you feel that people are pulling away from the traditional Christian standards here?
But we see that the Christian churches, especially I've seen in London, mostly closed. People are not interested, or the Christian leaders, they cannot make them interested.
Why? Did Christianity fail the people, which is why they're turning to other things?
Or? I think so.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You say that Hare Krishna consciousness pretty much takes the absolute truths from the Bible, the Quran, the Torah, and the Vedic.
Yeah, everywhere.
Everywhere.
Religion means to understand God.
I understand, but do you feel that in getting truths from various places like the Bible and the Quran and so forth, don't you run into conflicts at all or contradictions in those particular philosophies?
No, I don't find any conflict, because the ultimate goal is God. So you have to understand God and try to love Him. So you can go through any religious process. If the goal is attained, that you understand what is God, and you try to love Him, then your life is perfect.
Why do we see so many of your followers chanting almost all the time?
Chanting means to keep association with God always.
So you have to audibly chant Hare Krishna?
Yes. This is transcendental vibration. Just like a radio message, if you keep contact with the radio message, mm-hmm. Then you know everything, what is going on outside. Similarly, this transcendental sound, Hare Krishna, if you chant, then you keep connection with God directly.
Thank you very much, Your Divine Grace. It's been our privilege to talk with you and to meet you.
Thank you.
And hope that we can see you again when you return.
Hare Krishna.
We'll be back with more news in just a moment.
Bandeham Sri Guru Sri Juta Padakamalam Sri Guru Vaishna Vangsha Sri Rupam.